Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I will be predicting what the F1 grid could look like for the year 2023, and this will be the fifth year I will be doing this type of video for. And you can, if you like, go and check out how, for some of them awfully wrong, I have tried to predict the grid, but some of them correct as well. And so that can be the beauty of predicting. Nobody knows what's going to happen until it does. And so if you have your own predictions for what the grid could be like in 2023, then do feel free to comment down below what yours are. But without further ado, let's get into the first team, which as you can see will be Mercedes. And so currently at Mercedes for 2022 is Lewis Hamilton and George Russell, and they both have contracts till at least the end of 2023, so you would think that Mercedes will keep the same lineup for next season. But the big question could potentially be, does Hamilton stay on at Mercedes and in F1, or does he move on? And I do have a sneaky suspicion that what could potentially happen is that he does not race for Mercedes for next season. And what I think could potentially happen with Pierre Gasly out of contract at the end of the 2022 season, he could maybe join the Mercedes team for 2023. And so I'm going to be predicting that for the next season in 2023, it's going to be a lineup at Mercedes of George Russell and Pierre Gasly. And so starting off the video with a bit of a bold prediction there, but now we move on to Red Bull, who currently line up with Max Verstappen and Sergio Perez, and with the two drivers going to be most likely in a championship battle for the duration of this season, with Max Verstappen as of recording currently leading the championship and Sergio Perez just recently winning the Monaco Grand Prix and also signing a contract extension as well. And so that leads me to believe that the lineup for next season for Red Bull is going to stay the same and will be with Max Verstappen and Sergio Perez for another season for Red Bull. And so next up we have got Ferrari, who currently line up with Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz Jr. And they have now got a car which can challenge him for the title this season. And Leclerc has got a couple of wins to his name so far, but Carlos Sainz has not had the best of starts to his season, and so that could potentially put him on a little bit of danger of maybe losing his seat. But he does have a contract, as does his teammate Leclerc, until the end of 2024, and so for that reason I do think that it will be Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz again for the 2023 season. And so next up we have got McLaren, and they line up for this season with Lando Norris and Daniel Ricciardo. And so this season it has been Lando Norris who has got much the better of Daniel Ricciardo this season, and I did say last year in my predictions for this year that Daniel Ricciardo wouldn't really want to move teams again, as he has done so a few times now in recent seasons. And Ricciardo will have to majorly up his game if he is going to get that world championship that he does so desire, and maybe even up his game so that he just keeps his seat at the McLaren team as well, as it has not currently been worth the investment from McLaren. And so maybe they could be looking elsewhere despite Daniel Ricciardo's history of good performances, and they could potentially look to other series for drivers. And I think that what they could potentially do, it's a little bit bold this prediction, but I'm going to say that they're going to bring in Pato O'Ward from IndyCar into their McLaren F1 drive for the 2023 season. And so the next team on the agenda is going to be the Alpine team, and they currently in 2022 line up with Fernando Alonso and Esteban Ocon. And so in the 2022 season so far, it is Esteban Ocon who has beaten his teammate for points so far in the championship, with the Frenchman getting 75% of the team's points so far. And so I think it will unfortunately be the end of the F1 road for Fernando Alonso. And the team do have a very talented reserve driver who won the 2021 F2 championship in the form of Oscar Piastri, and I do think that he will get the second seat alongside Esteban Ocon for Alpine for the 2023 season. And so next up we have got the AlphaTauri team, and they currently line up with Pierre Gasly and Yuki Tsunoda. And so obviously if the prediction of Gasly moving teams to Mercedes is correct, then there is going to be a seat to fill at the AlphaTauri team. And so this one was a little bit of a last minute change of mind here, and I was originally going to put Liam Lawson alongside Yuki Tsunoda. However, I did realise that it's Felipe Drugovich who is currently leading the F2 Championship and is also part of the Red Bull programme. So I now think that it's going to be him, Felipe Drugovich, who is going to get the seat alongside Yuki Tsunoda for the 2023 season into the AlphaTauri team. And so next up we have got Aston Martin, and they currently line up with Sebastian Vettel and Lance Stroll. And now this one was another one where I changed my mind once or twice here. Despite this lineup being one that should in theory probably stay the same for next season, as we've got Lance Stroll's father having an ownership of the team and Sebastian Vettel investing in the long-term project of Aston Martin. However, he might decide to possibly retire at the end of this season from F1, and we also might not have Lance Stroll's father in charge of the team by the end of the season. We don't really know, but in the end, I have gone with Sebastian Vettel staying at the team, but Lance Stroll not staying at the team. And I am going to say that Daniel Ricciardo is going to join the team at Aston Martin and is going to see the return of the partnership of Sebastian Vettel and Daniel Ricciardo that we saw in 2014 at the Red Bull team, and will now potentially see it at the Aston Martin team for 2023 if this prediction is indeed correct. And now we're going to move on to the Williams team, as they currently line up with Alex Albon and with Nicholas Latifi, and it's Albon who has got some points for the team so far, whereas Latifi has not, and I think because of that, Latifi is going to get replaced for next season, and that is going to be with Nick De Vries, who is currently in Formula E but is going to make the switch over to Formula 1, I predict, for next season in the Williams team. And so next up is going to be the Alfa Romeo team, and they currently line up with Valtteri Bottas and Zhou Guan Yu, and it's Bottas who has majorly come out on top so far in this teammate battle, and I think that he will stay on for another year as per his contract, but Zhou Guan Yu has only got a 1 year contract at the team, and I think that maybe it's going to be someone else in that seat next year, and I predict that that driver could potentially be Teo Pourchaire to partner alongside Valtteri Bottas at Alfa Romeo for the 2023 season. And so finally we have got the Haas team, who currently line up with Kevin Magnussen and with Mick Schumacher. And currently it's Kevin Magnussen who has scored all the points for Haas so far, and unfortunately Mick Schumacher hasn't currently scored any so far, but I still think that he and Kevin Magnussen will still be at the team for next season, and so I think that it's going to be those two to remain at the team for next season for Haas. And that is going to conclude my predictions for the F1 grid for the 2023 season. And if you agree or if you disagree with any of the predictions that I've made, then do make sure to comment down below your thoughts. And so if you have enjoyed this video, then do leave a like, share the video around, and subscribe to the channel for more videos on F1. And so I will see you next time for another video, and goodbye.